sit back and let us be your leaders, God. We got a story we'd like to tell. We're gonna need help to tell it well. Boy, bunny.
As a DVD of the performance. There will also be a 50-50 raffle where the winners will be sold, sorry, the winners will be announced during intermission.
If any students in the audience would like to join the Alchemist, we'll be having a meeting on Tuesday, January 19th, where we will also be talking about our spring musical, Mary Poppins. So, sit back and let the cast of Theater U 2016 be your theater guides.
Next, where am I? Have you completed the form?
Sure was a long climb up.
Yes, have you completed the form?
Almost.
Almost?
Well, I just have one question.
A question?
Yeah.
Well?
About this one blink.
Which blank?
The one that says
yes.
Religion.
Do you believe in God? Do you believe in God?
I believe in Howard.
Howard? You believe in Howard?
It all has to do with my mother's maiden name.
Your mother's maiden name?
Was Howard. She was part of a big family in Memphis, the Howard family. So I grew up thinking to myself as a member of the Howard family.
What does that have to do with God?
Well, see, it's quite simple. What happened was I got packed off to Sunday school at around age 4. The first thing I learned was the Lord's Prayer, which begins, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. What I heard was, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Since little kids tend to mutter their prayers anyway, no one realized what I was saying. So I went right on believing that God's name was Howard, I was a member of his family, the Howards. Since I was also told that my grandfather had died and gone to heaven, God and my grandfather all mixed up as one and the same, which meant I had a pretty comfy notion about God. When I knelt beside my bed each night and prayed, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. I thought of my grandfather and what a big shot he was. I went to bed feeling pretty comfy about the whole universe for a long time.
You are putting me on, right?
No, not at all. I belong to the big scheme of things. I lived and worked and had my being in the family store. The whole universe was a Howard family enterprise.
So, do you still believe in Howard?
Let me put it this way. The 13th century Christian mystic, Meister Eckhart said, the eye with which I see God is the same eye with which God sees me.
What the hell is that?
Not only do I believe in Howard, but Howard believes in me.
Thank you. flashing eyes,
your brilliant brain, your brutal thighs. These are the tools you've got in your command
to make her mine.
To keep her mine.
To make her mine.
Your crooked smiles.
You're in a fire that sparks romance, that sparks desire.
Cuddly, grungy,
you've got what the ladies cry for, crafty, kind.
You are what they gladly die for, talent, genius. You're the stuff that dudes are made of. Demon lover, what have you to be afraid of? What have you to be afraid of? You're almost perfect, but one thing is true. Need her desperately, but she does not need you.
She runs the show. She leads the band. The royal flush is in her hand.
Little boy, you can't afford to fail. Must not fail. Dare not fail. Will not fail.
So flash that wit, flash those eyes, and use that brain,
and use those thighs. Hey team, yay team, break right through the line! There is no stronger challenge than an independent woman. You can do it,
you can do it.
Got to keep her,
got to make her mine.
Thank you.
think it is. The thing I do with my eyes.
Well, I'm not going to pretend I know what it is, Matilda, but I don't believe it's something to be frightened of. I think it has something to do with that incredible mind of yours.
So you mean there's not enough room in my head for my brains, so they have to squish out through my eyes?
Not exactly, but something like that. You certainly are a very special girl, Matilda. I met your mother. She's unusual. How about your father? Is he proud to have a girl as clever as you are?
Oh yes, he's very proud. He's very, very, very proud. He's always saying, Matilda, I'm so proud to have a daughter. That's not true, Miss Honey. That's not what he says. He's not proud at all. He's always calling me a liar, and a cheat, and a nasty little creep.
I see. Oh, here we are, home sweet home.
Are you poor?
Yes, I am.
I thought they paid teachers very well.
Not exactly, but you see, I'm poorer than most for other reasons. When I was younger, I lived with my aunt, and one day I was out walking in the woods, and I came across this little shed. I fell in love with it. I ran to the farmer and begged him to buy it. He looked at me like I was mad. But he sold it to me, and I've been living here ever since.
But, Miss Honey, you can't live in a shed.
I'm not strong like you, Matilda. When I was very young, my father died. Magnus was his name. And when he was gone, my aunt became my legal guardian. She was mean and cruel and horrible like you could never imagine. When I got my job teaching, she suddenly presented me with a bill for looking after me all those years. She had written everything down, every tea bag, every electricity bill, every tin of beans. And she made me sign a contract promising to pay back every penny. She even presented me with a document saying that my father had given her his entire house.
Did he really do that? Magnus, did he really just give her his house?
I don't know. I mean, I find it hard to believe. Just like I find it hard to believe that he would have killed himself, which is what she said happened.
You think she did him it, don't you, Miss Honey?
I cannot say. All I know is that years of being bullied by that woman made me pathetic. I was trapped.
And that's why you live here.
Indeed it is. Matilda, this isn't just a shed. This is my house. This is the place that I can call my own.
Doing that to me.
But everyone wants to come to New York.
You keep your small life in a big city. Give me a big life in a small town. They say folks is dying to get here. Me, I'm dying to get away to a little town out west that's spanking new. And though I ain't ever been there, I can see it clear as day. If you want, I bet you could see it too. Close your eyes, come with me, where it's clean and green and pretty. And they went and made a city out of clay. Why, the minute that you get there, Folks will walk right up and say, "Welcome home, son, welcome home to Santa Fe." Planting crops, splitting rails, swapping tails around the fire, except for Sundays when you lie around all day. Soon your friends are more like family, and they's begging you to stay. Ain't that neat? Living sweet in Santa Fe. About no Kim Plague in Santa Fe. You just hop a Palomino, you ride in style.
Feature me riding in style.
Hey, I bet a few months of clean air, you can trust that old crutch for good. Santa Fe, you can bet we won't let them bastards beat us. We won't beg no one to treat us fair and square. There's a life that's worth the living, and I'm gonna do my share. Work the land, chase the sun, swim the whole Rio Grande just for fun. Watch me stand. Watch me run. Hey, don't you know that we's a family? Would I let yous down? No way. Just hold on again till that train makes Santa Fe.
Well, I posted a pic on Insta and it only got 3 likes.
Yeah! I'm literally dying!
Yeah!
That's not a lot of likes!
Yeah, I know. And one of them was my dad!
Yeah, no! Wow! I know how to get a lot of likes. Let's take up a selfie! A best friends forever selfie! The selfie! OMG! It looks so good! I love it!
We are adorable!
Elbow to elbow, hand in hand, we're best friends until the end! Alright, now it's time for a new segment on the show called the Ale Sing-Off. I'll go first. Okay, now you go. I don't think I can top that, but ew, I'll try.
Yield signs! Yeah.
He's like a total hottie. I can't.
Then don't.
Yeah, like, seriously, don't.
Okay, one more. Theater kids! Ah!
Well, that's all the time we have for today. I'd like to thank Brittany and Allison for joining me once again. Tune in next time. Bye!
We're fighting over? Yeah, she's no ordinary woman. You really don't know how good you had it. Well, if I'm gonna die, I want the world to know how great she really is. Why do you want me to shut up? Are you afraid? Are you afraid I'll say something to hurt your feelings? Are you that scared? Are you gonna cry, softy? Okay then. Listen. Punch me all you want when I'm done. Beat me to a pulp. Just let me say how I feel for her. Do this one kindness for her. She's worth it. Do you know what serendipity is? Is that word too big for you? I should probably stick to one or two syllables while speaking to you. Serendipity is a happy accident, a pleasant surprise, a fortunate mistake. Well, more specifically, an action of something good happening while not specifically searching for it. You see, that's what our love was. A happy accident. We didn't plan on this. She's wonderful. She's amazing. She's so very good. She's made me happier than I ever thought possible. Before her, my world was in black and white. But then, she brought color to my world. And by some miracle, she chose me. I mean, don't get me wrong. I thought she was wonderful and all, but I never thought in a million years that she would choose me. And you know, she'll always be the princess to my Popper. She'll be the Batman to my Robin. The Katniss Everdeen to my Peter Malone. Or Gale, depending on your preference. But she chose me. Oh, and don't even get me started on her kisses. They'll last until death. Which may not be far off. Yes, we're talking about the same woman, you idiot! Okay. Now you can punch me.
Bed bugs.
Bed bugs.
Bed bugs.
Bed bugs.
Movie theaters, Restaurants?
Gross.
Your house?
Disgusting.
You know how bimbos get in your house.
Why, how?
They ride in on the backs of mice.
What?
Marauding armies of bimbos galloping in on mice.
I'm gonna be sick.
So you got bimbos. Well, congratulations. You also got mice.
Hey, guess what, bimbos? Do me a favor. Take a hike. I invite you. Grab your saddles, jump on your tiny mice, and ride yourselves out of my house.
Giddy up, giddy out.
All right.
Fine.
Listen to the guest.
Oh, the guest. I know. Tell me about it.
All right.
Here we
go.
Let's do it.
Okay.
Buckle up.
Here we go.
Here we go.
Okay. I can't read this. It's like chicken scratch. Who wrote this?
It's mine. I'm sorry.
You're a terrible type of chip.
I'm a mess.
Well, okay. You did the best you could. All right. Let's just,
you know what? On that,
tell us his name.
Yeah.
Let's
bring him on.
Go.
Come on.
Let's go. Come on.
All right. Come on.
Come on.
Tell us.
Any day.
Come on.
You almost done.
So close.
There you go.
All right. Well done. Okay.
Hey. Good.
Hello. My name is Frank O'Connor.
Oh my
god!
Wow! Look at him!
Come on, look at you!
So cute!
Gorgeous!
Oh,
did you write a
book
for that?
Yes.
Oh my
god!
Jeez!
Those eyes!
Let me ask you, Frank, are you Indian?
What
you a little bit of
what are you, a Apache?
What are you,
a Chippewa? Wait a minute, Mohegan!
You go gambling in a Mohegan sun, you go to Foxwood. Come on, tell us, Frank.
Tell us, come on.
No.
Got some Sioux in you.
Wait,
what about
Sioux?
Sioux?
Got some
Sioux?
Sioux?
Come on,
Sioux?
Wait,
Sioux?
Well, tell us.
I'm Irish Italian.
temper. That's a terrible mix.
Not features-wise, no. Not features-wise, obviously.
No,
not temperament.
No.
Awful bargain.
No.
So, tell us where your book is about to be, huh?
Go.
It's a guide to the best mountain biking trails in the United States.
Right.
Yeah.
So, are you married, Frank?
Well, I have a girlfriend.
Why don't you ask your girlfriend to marry you?
Oh, Jody, tell everyone the big news.
Oh, it's not a big deal.
Her and her husband renewed their vows.
Yeah, whatever.
Tell us everything.
Okay. So everybody knows I hate my stupid husband. Can't stand him. So I have a near-death experience. I've seen him come out, changing a light, because of course he won't. So, toilet seat is away. Long story short, I saw a light. Bathed in the light, my dead auntie Joanne.
She died?
Hey, I didn't know that. She was so old. Okay, so I passed out. My stupid husband's giving mouth to mouth to me. Next thing you know, we start making out. Boom, we're renewing our vows.
Yes, she goes.
What can I do?
Here she goes.
I love this stupid guy. Give me my three kids. Save my life.
Okay, you know what? Do whatever you want. Okay, what are we, experts or something?
Yeah,
right, what you want.
We don't care.
Okay,
do whatever you want.
So this book of yours, right? You like to ride bikes?
Yes. I traveled all over the country and rated them according to difficulty and size.
Yeah. You know how many times I had dinner with my husband this year, Frankie?
No.
0.00 times. My kitchen table, it's got the Ghostbusters thing over it. No one goes in there.
No trespassing.
Close to business.
The red circle thing
with the line, the Ghostbusters thing?
Yeah.
It's my choice. You know what I say?
You know what I say when my husband wants me to cook the dinner for him?
What?
I say to him, go ask Angelina Jolie.
Am I right,
ladies? Come on.
No.
Angelina Jolie, take a
look.
She's a tabloid. She's some...
Nobody wants you.
No more.
No.
Done.
Take
it over.
Go home.
Done.
No.
Go ahead.
Bye.
Over.
Thank you very much, Frank.
Yes, thank you.
Bye-bye. Have a nice
time. I'll let you book.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Thanks.
Bye-bye. Okay.
Oh my god.
That one.
So
precious.
The face.
The face was good.
I love the face.
I love them.
Let me ask you though. Did you smell that weird smell in the city the other day?
Weird.
The whole city smelled like garbage.
Oh my god. The whole city. It smelled like a pickle.
Just like a pickle. You're right.
A pickle.
Just like a pickle.
It smelled like a pickle.
A pickle.
You know what pickles is? It smells like me cooking fish in the house.
When my husband tries to bring the fish in the house, you know what I say to him?
What? I say,
go ask Angelina Jolie to cook that for you.
Why are we talking about this one again?
I can't stand her.
Why is she here?
I saw her in the top of the shop, right?
No.
Done.
No, never again.
Quiet. Never again.
You know what? I'm
no more her.
I don't even want to talk about her anymore.
Quiet.
I'm done.
Okay. I'm done.
I'm done with her. Okay. But you know who I miss?
Who?
That kid.
Frankie.
Let's get it back out here.
Okay, let's do it.
Okay.
Jenna?
Jenna,
where is he? Where'd he go?
He's in the bathroom.
He's in the bathroom?
Knock on the door.
Get him back out here.
King of England.
Come on.
Why is this? Get it back out here. Come on.
Okay.
Sit down.
Should I bring my book?
No, sit down.
You're adorable.
You're adorable.
Yeah, just sit down.
Go sit down.
Okay.
brushes.
He's still so adorable.
Okay,
I have to ask, it's so cute.
Are you a Leo?
Who are you, a Leo?
A Taurus?
Taurus?
Got some Aries.
Aries?
Got Capricorn?
Okay, Capricorn?
Yes, you're a Leo.
Oh,
got a Sue.
Sue?
Got Sue Leo.
Leo Sue.
What is Sue?
I'm a Gemini.
Oh! Twin.
You know what? He's a good boy. You know why?
Why?
Because he's good to his mother. You love your mother, don't you, Frankie?
Look at his face! Look at his face!
Look at his eyes!
Oh my gosh!
Precious.
So precious.
Okay.
Back to business.
Right.
Okay.
So this book.
Yes.
We have to hear all about it.
Dying to know.
Tell us.
Okay. Well, I've been writing for years.
Right.
And just...
Yes. So that's all the time we have on both of you. Very sorry. But we'll see you next time.
look like I'm sweating. Well, that's because I am. I'm not good with words. That's nothing new. Still, I have to try to explain what I want to do with you. With you. Run away with me. Let me be your ride out of town. Let me be the place that you hide. We can make our lives on the go. Run away with me. Texas in the summer is cool. We'll be on the road like Jack Kerouac. Looking back, getting ready, let's go.
No, 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 no. Sing Speak your mind and you'll be heard.
If Troy can be a singer, then I'm coming clean. I play the cello.
Awesome! A song!
No, dude, it's like a giant violin.
Not another word.
Code and tie.
No, no, no.
Photo. desire. Am I not to feel? If I ache to taste, am I not to try? If my heart says sail, why should I deny? I have my dreams, I have made plans, I see horizons wide as a man's. Must I be nothing till I'm some man's wife? Look at this face, does it deceive? Do I look made to milk and to weave? I will be damned to hell if that is my life. I'm almost your age, or match in size, I'm as skilled with swords and equal in most eyes. But when you have a dream and you're caught in its grip, you can climb aboard a ship, you can, for you're a man. You can restore that place where the be true. If you can do it, why not I? I meant to fly, sail unrestrained. Why is man free and woman chained? Is that my epitaph before I die? I should be free, free to be graced, so I can feel the wind on my face. And when life beckons, I should go face up the storm. No, not I.
Always like to stop time. What can I do? Protect your gate!
Go to our freaks!
Do you know
darling, when the chess team makes fun of you?
Ariana, I once dreamed of going out with you.
Oh, Glenn.
But now I don't even think so. And Craig, I'm not sure. But I think I can kick your ass. Now pipe down, you two losers. It's my move!
Oh my gosh!
What do you want from us?
He's so mad! He's in such good shape!
I get it, like, what's going on?
I know what he wants.
The perfect cheer!
And we go a little something like this. Hit it. I think. Come on. But like Big Jack said, I can't get no satisfaction. The girls are all around, but none of them want to get with me. My threads are fresh and I'm looking deaf. Yo, what's up, what I don't see? The girls are so shocked at the other end of the wall. Have a dream with some no way chump when they know that I was strong. So what I'm showing up to the other side of the team. I asked the guy why he's so fine. He said, come on, go with me.
Today's big day. It's finally arrived.
I never thought I'd make it here.
I'm so excited to start this new chapter in my life. Graduation day. Today, a huge weight will be lifted from my shoulders. Yeah, I'm going to Princeton. But that doesn't mean I didn't tear myself apart to get there. Truth be told, I almost died.
Every single time I looked in the mirror. For years, I thought I was too short, too fat, too ugly. I found that the only thing that made me feel better was bullying other kids.
Kids in my grade never had to deal with anything like I did. And I was a good student too. Up until the car crash.
Every night at home, Mom and Dad would fight. I knew their marriage was failing, and it hurt me like you wouldn't believe. So I hoped that one day it would get better, and that hope gave me
motivation is key, they always told me. I guess that was true. I was constantly motivated by the fear of getting anything less than an A.
The girl once cried right in front of me because I made fun of the size of her ears. On the inside, I felt horrible. But on the outside, I just laughed. Laughed. I knew deep in my gut, I shouldn't have done
that. That was the worst day of my life. When I got the call that my mom has died, I couldn't stop crying. I cried for her. I cried for myself. I cried for my dad when he turned to alcohol to numb the pain. But mostly I cried for my little brother, Thomas. He'll never know our mom. When it happened, he was only four.
Four times a week, they went to a marriage counselor. Never helped, and I knew it. Still, I tried to remain positive and keep a smile on my face. I pulled through by working hard in school and joining lots of clubs.
Clubs and sports? I never had time for. All of my energy was spent pulling all-nighters, trying to achieve perfection.
Perfection was something I could never reach. Even though I continued to cause pain, I still felt like I wasn't happy.
Happy was something that I never was. I spent countless hours making sure Thomas was okay. Everything was about Thomas. All my time and energy were spent on Thomas. I mean, I didn't mind, I guess. But I knew I was too young
to do anything, so I just let it happen. No matter how bad it had seemed in the moment, I always kept up hope that one day their marriage would get better.
I needed to be better. That's what Mom and Dad always said. How could I be better when I was already at my best? That's when I decided to take a few too many pills. I couldn't keep living my life like that.
That ate me up inside. People feared me in the hallway. I just wanted to be liked, but I heard once that to have people like you, you need to like yourself.
First time I cut school, it wasn't a big deal. Thomas needed me, and I needed the day off. But eventually, it became a habit.
The fights? They never stopped. They were planning the day they were going to sign the papers, but I didn't care. I knew that one day I'd be able to get through it, and now, here I am. Alive. Ready to take on a life at Princeton, without my parents breathing down my neck. I'll finally have independence. I can finally be free.
Free is what I will never be. Even though I continue to cause pain, I still felt like I wasn't happy.
A new start is something I won't see for a long time. Thomas still needs me. And to be honest, I'm surprised he even made it to graduation.
The big day. I'm so excited. For all those years, I never let my hardship define me because I knew once I graduated from school, I would graduate from the pain, at least for a little while.
Wow, this is an end to a life I was so used to. It's also the end to a life I didn't want to live. It's a new chapter, a new beginning, a new chance. I have to start over, redeem myself. Maybe even apologize to Rebecca for all the crap I shouted at her in the hallway and didn't really mean.
Means it's time to maybe recreate myself, even if that means going to people for help, for advice, especially on Thomas, and to stay positive.
Those will forever be the words I live by. I know that by keeping them in mind, I'll be able to get through anything and everything will be okay. It'll be all right. Because here we are.
All from different beginnings.
All ending up at the same place.
And now going down different paths with different endings.
So congratulations
to the graduating class.
You wrote a poem about me. You are, oh, you are so in love, Shane.
And Billy said to the barrel boy, is this the way you ride? Are you going to interrupt me after every line?
I'm
because
sorry.
I can't keep going and you're going to do that.
Word.
There is a flow, a
I'm
rhythm
sorry.
To these things, and I can't keep going.
Mothers. I see it.
Billy said to the barrel boy, is this the way you ride? In a car going 90 per machine gun on each side. I've only got a pinter horse and a six-gun tried and true. I would shoot, but they got me. And someday, they will get you.
Would you write that? Well, that's a lousy thing to write.
It's dramatic.
It's stupid.
Don't you call my poetry stupid.
Let me write stuff like
that.
How do I ever get it? I'm so far
from you. You're so ignorant. Thought about that before you called my poetry stupid. Don't you laugh at me.
I am sorry, sugar.
Don't you ever laugh at me. I'm going to be famous. I'm going to be an actress, a poet, and a singer.
A singer, huh? Well, let's hear something.
Not in the mood.
Oh, come on. I really want to hear you sing. Unless it's also going to be about me getting shot up. Hey, you're in a nightclub in that there Atlantic City. Me and Capone sing ringside. The crowd is going crazy. Bonnie, Bonnie, Bonnie.
How about a dance? What do you say? I've got some moves that I love to show you. Let's find a spot and dance the night.
Tonight is the night I've been waiting for. Even the moon looks just right. I'm sure the crowd will make room on the floor when they see you.
Everything in front of me is blank. And the one bright second when I know what I want, but I still haven't turned the key. I have to savor this. I have to remember how it feels to want something so much that you'll risk regretting. Can you do that? Can you do something as simple as not know where you're going? Like to see the sinking underneath your waves. The sky is pale with morning light.
Oh. that he married me beat him. That's what he said, that's what he said. When he proposed, he informed my mother this was probably her very last chance. And though she was 22, though she was 22, though she was 22, she married him. Life with my dad wasn't ever a picnic, more of a come as you are. When I was 5, I remember my mother dug earrings out of the car. I knew that they weren't hers, but it wasn't something they wanted to discuss. He wasn't warm. Well, not to her. Well, not to us. But everything was beautiful at the ballet. Up a steep and very narrow stairway to the voice like a metronome. Up a steep and very narrow stairway. It wasn't paradise.
It wasn't paradise.
It wasn't paradise, but it was home.
Mother always said I'd be very attractive when I grew up, when I grew up. She said with a special something and a very, very personal flair. And though I was 8 or 9, though I was 8 or 9, though I was 8 or 9, I hated her. Now, different is nice, but it sure isn't pretty. Pretty is what it's about. I never met anyone who was different who couldn't figure that out. So beautiful, I never lived to see. It was clear, if not to her, well then to me. But everyone was beautiful at the ballet. Every prince has got to have his swan.
Daddy, I would love.
Well, so you're going to be the new coach, right?
Yes.
Well, then you must know all the names of the players.
Of course.
See, I've never met the guys, so you'll have to tell me that, so that when I go there, I can get to know them better.
Okay. Well, I gotta warn you. These ball players nowadays have really odd names.
You mean, funny names?
Peculiar names, like a... like Dizzy Dean.
And his brother Daffy.
Daffy Dean?
And their French cousin.
French?
Gouffet.
Gouffet Dean. Anyway, well, we have the bet. We have who's on first, what's on second, I don't know who's on third.
That's what I'm trying to find out.
I said who's on first, what's on second, I don't know who's on third.
You're the manager?
Yes.
You're going to be the coach, too.
Yes.
And you don't know the fellas' names.
Well, I should.
Well, then tell me, who's on first?
Yes.
I mean the man's name.
Who?
The guy.
Who?
The first baseman.
Who?
The guy playing.
Who's on first?
I'm asking you who's on first.
That's the man's name.
That's whose name?
Yes.
Go ahead and tell me.
That's it.
That's who?
Yes.
Look, you got a first baseman?
Of course.
Who's playing first?
Yes.
When you pay off the first baseman every month, who gets the money?
Every dollar of it.
All I'm trying to find out is the man's name on first base.
Who?
The guy.
Who?
The guy that gets the money.
Who gets the money?
All I'm trying to find out is what's the guy's name on first base?
No, what's on second base?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
One piece at a time!
Then stop changing the players around!
I'm not changing nobody!
Take it easy, buddy.
When you sign up the first baseman, how does he sign his name?
Who?
The guy.
Who?
How does he sign
his name? That's how he signs it.
Who?
Yes.
You got a first baseman?
Of course.
Who's playing first?
Yes.
All right.
Okay.
What's the guy's name on first base?
No, what's on second base?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
I don't know!
He's on third. We're not talking about him.
Now, how did I get on third base?
You mentioned his name.
If I mentioned the third baseman's name, who did I say is playing third?
No, who's playing first?
What's on first?
No, what's on second?
I...
He's on third.
There I go, back to third again.
Look, would you just stay on third base? Don't go off.
All right? What do you want to know?
Who's playing third base?
Why do you insist on putting who on third base?
What am I putting on third base?
No, what's on second?
You don't want who on second.
No, who's on first?
I don't know.
Third base.
You got an outfield on this team?
Of course.
The left fielder's name.
Why? I just thought I'd tell you.
Then go ahead.
Why?
Can you just tell me who's playing left field?
Who's not playing left field? Who's playing first?
I'm not. Stay out of the infield. I want to know what's the left fielder's name.
No, what's on second?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
I don't know. Third base.
Ha 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 ha!
left fielder's name?
What?
Because.
Oh, that's our center fielder.
You got a pitcher on this team?
Of course.
The pitcher's name?
Tomorrow.
You don't want to tell me today?
I'm telling you now.
Then go ahead.
Tomorrow.
What time?
What time what?
What time tomorrow are you going to tell me who's pitching?
Who's not pitching?
I'll break your arm, you say, who's on first. I want to know, what's the pitcher's name?
No, what's on second?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
I don't know.
Third base.
You got a catcher on this team?
Of course.
The catcher's name?
Today.
Today. And tomorrow's pitching?
Now you got it.
All we've got are a couple of days on the team. You know, I'm a catcher too.
So they tell me.
So I get behind the plate to do a little fancy catching. Tomorrow's pitching on my team, and a heavy hitter gets him. Now the head hitter bunts the ball. When he bunts the ball, me being a good catcher, I'm gonna pick up the ball and get the guy out first. So I pick up the ball, but to who?
Now that's the first thing you said right.
I don't even know what I'm talking about anymore.
That's all you have to do.
Is throw the ball to first base.
Yes.
Now who's got it?
Naturally.
Ball to first base, somebody's gotta have it. Now who has it?
Naturally.
Who?
Naturally.
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 So I get the ball and I throw it to naturally.
No, you throw it to who?
Naturally.
That's different.
That's what I said.
No, you're saying it wrong.
I throw the ball naturally.
No, you throw it to who?
Naturally.
That's it.
That's what I say!
Here, you ask me.
I throw the ball to who?
Naturally.
Now you ask me.
You throw the ball to who?
Naturally.
That's it.
Same as you. I throw the ball to who? Whoever it is drops the ball and the guy runs to second. Who picks up the ball and throws it to what? What throws it to, I don't know, throws it back to tomorrow. Triple play. Another guy gets up and hits a long fly ball out to because. Why? I don't know. He's on third, and I don't give a darn.
What?
I said, I don't give a darn.
Oh, that's our shortstop.
That's our shortstop.
Tall, glaring and raring a brawl. Armies of guys who are sick of the lies, getting ready to rise to the fall.